In this video, I'm going to explain two parts of brain. They are this area. This red area is primary motor cortex. This blue area is primary somatosensory cortex. Primary motor cortex sends the order to muscle. Like when you want to move fingers and hands, particular part of the cortex sends order to muscle. Okay? Compared to primary motor cortex, primary somatosensory cortex takes information from different part of the body. So let me explain which part of the cortex sends information to muscle and which part of the primary somatosensory cortex receives information from which part of the body. Now let me remove right hemisphere of cerebrum. Okay, this is left hemisphere. This red part is primary motor cortex. This is primary somatosensory cortex. This is cingulate gyrus. These two cortex begin above cingulate gyrus. So let me explain this part. This part basically sends information to lower extremity. Foot, lower leg, leg and hip. You can say same thing for primary somatosensory cortex. This part receives information from lower extremity, like lower leg, hip, and thigh. And this top part is also the lower extremity, like hip joint. So, toe, foot, lower leg, and hip joint. This area is about trunk, you know, trunk. Then it goes to upper extremity, this part. This part of primary motor cortex sends information to upper extremity. Now, this part of primary somatosensory cortex receives information from upper extremity. Now, let's go to the lateral part of the brain. This part is about face, like, you know, eye or nose and tongue, this area. So, this area is lower extremity, this area. This area is trunk, upper extremity. Then, face. Easy way to remember is this part is lower than the upper part, right? That's why this is lower extremity, because this part is physically lower than this part, right? Lower extremity and upper extremity. Rest is face. This is how I remember. Now, there's another confusing part. Sometimes I'm confused. Wait a second. Which one is anterior? Is that primary motor cortex anterior? Or is primary somatosensory cortex anterior? Okay, here is how you remember. Basically, primary motor cortex is anterior. Okay? Now, when you walk, which direction do you go? Do you go anterior, front? Or do you walk to posterior? You walk towards anterior, right? Is walking movement or sensory? It's movement, right? That's why primary motor cortex is anterior. Now it's elimination. Then primary somatosensory cortex is posterior. Here's how I remember. Primary motor cortex, walking, anterior. Now, primary somatosensory is posterior. I think it's pretty good way to remember. Now, I want to add one more thing relation to the blood supply. There are two arteries supply this cortex. This area is supplied by anterior cerebral artery, about this area. Now, rest is supplied by middle cerebral artery. Now, what happens if anterior cerebral artery gets occlusion? Occlusion is like stroke. It means less blood supply. Okay, what happens if this part of artery gets occlusion? Okay, now, do you remember which part of the cortex has relationship? It's lower extremity, right? So if this part of artery gets occlusion, that dysfunction can happen to the other side of lower extremity. Because this is left hemisphere, this information goes to opposite side. So if left side anterior cerebral artery gets occlusion, right side lower extremity gets weakened or paralysis. Okay, now what happens if middle cerebral artery gets occlusion? Do you remember which part of cortex controls this part? That's upper extremity and face. So if this part gets occlusion, the symptoms shows up to the other side of upper extremity and face. I will repeat that again. This part is supplied by anterior cerebral artery. This part is lower extremity. If this part gets occlusion, the other side of lower extremity gets weakened or paralysis. If middle cerebral artery gets occlusion, the other side of upper extremity and face gets weakened or paralysis. This area is very important. This kind of question is very famous for exam. Okay. So today's review, what is this cortex? This is primary motor cortex. This blue one is primary somatosensory cortex. Which one is anterior? Primary motor cortex is anterior because when you walk, you go to forward. It's walking movement or sensory. It's more like movement, right? That's why primary motor cortex, walking forward, anterior. Primary somatosensory cortex is posterior. This part is lower extremity. And this part is trunk. The rest is upper extremity and face. That's easy, right? Lower extremity because it's physically lower than upper extremity part. Okay? Now, this part is vascularized by anterior cerebral artery. The rest of part is supplied by middle cerebral artery. I know it's very confusing, it's a lot of information, but understanding the anatomy and function and vascularization is very important for clinical experience. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.